Let me ask you a little question.
Hello everyone, how are you feeling? Are we in conversation at Garden Point?
You can answer our question.
Pardon?
You can answer our question.
I thought I did.
What does it mean?
Okay, that means I have to take it through each of them. Okay. So the first chant is from folklore, is from Yoruba culture, which is basically talking about the power of poetry and proverbs. It's a relation of that is words or etching is us. So it's like saying proverbs are the locomotive for words, so to speak. when all sense is lost, you can use proverbs to bring it back, so to speak. So that was because I'm about poetry, I'm about culture, I'm about identity, and I feel that speaks to what I do. So I decided to open the folklore. But I didn't write that.
But your Rikist, your Riki says that you are twin, right?
Yeah.
And, but that's I'm starting. That's the first thing I wrote. That's the third thing. And there's the Oriki, family Oriki. That part, I wrote that part, right? Say Ade Bola Ishola Oma Ade. Ishola is my Oriki. Most Yoruba folks would have that middle name that speaks to their heritage. So my Oriki is Ishola. I'm Oma Ade because I'm actually a prince. My dad is a king. So I was basically trying to channel the power and the beauty of my heritage, you know. Ishola Omade, Omo Iyola Shemi. So my forefather is Iyola Shemi. Omade Gwega, my dad is Ade Gwega, Ishola, Omo Takwa. So in my town where we're from, we are deemed to have come migrated from Bida in the state of today to where we settled in Kwara State now, which is Ojoku Town. Anybody who knows Kwara, that's some 10 minutes drive from Ofa in Kwara State. So we migrated from Bida. Yeah, so we have Mupe roots, really. I don't speak Mupe, I'm more Yoruba than anything. But generations ago, way before
well, Shango married a Papa woman and brought the Papas into the Yoruba.
Yeah. So way before the Usman and Mupe was,
like,
you know, way back.
You know that one.
I remember as a 9-year-old, my dad studied history for his first degree. So I was going through books in his library. I'm a voracious reader. So I was reading that book and I remember the works of a particular explorer that I found. I can't remember the name. I remember discussing with my dad recently, so it's something I can easily retrieve. And he spoke about my forefather. Think about the Mungo Park age. There wasn't colonialism there. These guys were just exploring Africa, traveling around and writing stories and taking, you know. The way he described the palace, the majesty, and, you know, I was really, really proud, you know. This generations away that was, but the fact that I had documented history that gave me a picture of what my forefathers were like. He didn't wake up till like 11 a.m. in the morning, the drummer had to drum, we had his sports, so many, you know, think of when you went on this Egyptian palace setting, think of a pharaoh kind of setting in the movie. He got up, went to have his bath, there were women, there were women, it was so beautiful, you know. So these were things that were at the back of my mind when I was writing that. So I was talking about Yola Shemi Omotakpa. And that was the personal part, which is saying that in Yoruba, really, nothing else to it. And I think it's really, really simple. I didn't use any people about it. It's really simple. Then the last part is also from folklore. I'm a twin. I've got a twin brother. Whenever I went to FGC, if you remember Desperate, that's my twin brother. That's his name.
That's his nickname.
He was very troublesome. My twin brother was a terror. Yeah, he's a farmer, he's in Ilorin at the moment. He shot to Lagos and Ilorin. Yeah. So, you know, so the second part is Oriki Beji. This is from folklore. Isokun is like
two ropes tied.
Yeah. So he's saying it's like of another realm. It's believed that twins are from that heavenly pantheon, so to speak. So Ijara is so called twins, like blessings from outer space, so to speak. Every job be around must say, how do I explain that now? Well, I'll skip that. I didn't write that part, so I'm very upfront with that. That's from Yoruba folklore. Nobody can claim ownership of it. It's in the culture. It's a chant for twins. So I just channel it because I'm a twin. Yes. So, Odeikelekun twins are regarded as blessings. So Odeikelekun, when he has arrived, the house is full. Because it's a blessing.
And you carry them with two hands.
Tell me, you brought blessings. It's metaphorical. Like, think of twins as things like when you come in, the whole place is filled with luggage and goodies and gifts and wealth and all that. Odeikelekun, winning, Odeikelekun. The one that makes the rival of his mom or their mom jealous. Orubu is rival. Polygamy. So like winning, like jealous. How I reach out to it. Winning, Loju Orubu is more Loju Yari. The duo in the eyes of the mom. So the mom also like, oh, it's twins. You know, Yoruba see twins as gods, as idols. And there's Orisha Deji that is worshipping beans. Beans with red oil, and there are other foods like
beans with red oil, beans with agbado,
or with agbado as well. So there are specific foods in Yoruba culture that are deemed as. That is very nonsense, yeah.
What are the colors?
It's mixed, especially that the beans will become corn and the corn will become beans. You don't understand it.
It's called a bow. There's also something interesting that I don't want to digress. So I lived in Swaziland. I spent almost 1 year there. And I met Congolese, and I actually shared my time between Lagos and Cape Town and South Africa. I realized that that food is actually African, north to mid to west and south. That beans and corn is arguably the only food that I see that you can find in every culture. It can taste slightly different. I've seen it in Kenya as well. I've eaten it there. It tastes different. I don't know that.
do you eat it to remind yourself of your
childhood? Because the season that you used to go in your bag. But it's interesting to discover that in my travels across Africa to find. But in our culture, as Yorubas, is deemed doesn't stop the average person from eating it. It's a staple food. It's seen as such. You're welcome, my brother. Nice to see you. It was at my performance yesterday. Yeah. So. It's a staple food, but it's been assigned to twins. So if you want to go back to twins, eat a lot of beans. I'm just saying, you know, the light meat. So where are we with the translation of the?
You are lost in translation. Lost in translation. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm already on the third part. That's the folklore part. Ejuwaloju, or Bekisi, Bekese, that is the overly excited one. Who, you know, jump.
We are talking
about it. Rez, you know that this is deep. You've never done this anywhere else.
I've never had to break down this iron piece like this.
Yeah.
Piece.